Well, this is Joe Van Cleve. Good afternoon. Welcome to my office. And I would like to show you a little bit of kind of a show and tell and an idea for an art project you might want to consider. So I made these maybe about a decade ago almost. And what these are, I'll show you close up in a minute here. These are little photograms of leaves that I've essentially contact printed leaves against fiber-based paper, developed them, and then I figured out a way to display them that kind of works well with the fact that it is metallic silver emulsion image and it's a leaf. So let's look at the close-up of what I did here, and maybe this will give you guys some creative ideas. Okay, so these are three examples of silver gelatin photograms. Photograms are like contact prints, but instead of printing a photographic negative onto paper, you're printing another kind of an object that's semi-translucent or transparent, or it could be opaque if you want just a silhouette. These are little leaves, and this is the actual size of the leaf. And what I've done is I've taken little pieces of Ilford multi-grade fiber-based printing paper, and I've set them down face up in the dark room, and I put a leaf on top, and then I've sandwiched a piece of glass on top of it, and then done the contact print exposure, developed it, and so it has a really nice appearance. Now, one of the things I really love about these is that they have a slight curl to them, you might notice. The paper, this is a natural property of fiber-based paper, that the emulsion, which is on the front side of the paper, tends to shrink when it dries, and it will pull the paper toward the front, causing it to kind of curl. And what I like about this, the subject matter being a leaf, it kind of takes on a leaf-like curl to the appearance of the paper. Now, each one of the leaves is different. No two leaves are alike, and these leaves are from three different kinds of shrubs and around my property. And what I've done is I'm using thin steel wire, pierced a tiny hole in the top of each print, and I'm suspending the prints from this little wire from a little aluminum frame. These frames are about an inch wide, and they're made from little scraps of thin aluminum that I cut on a paper trimmer, and then I took a wire brush on a drill, and I kind of wire brushed these so it has that brushed aluminum look. And then I bent these pieces and pop riveted them. The joints are pop riveted together. So it's pretty simple to make these. This is easier to make than, certainly, than a wooden picture frame. Now, to display these pictures, you can either use two little brads in the wall, one in each corner, or you can put one in the center. And you can suspend, hang them on the wall. If you do that, the area, the blank area between the picture and the frame, kind of acts like your mat board. It gives you like a border around the picture. The other way of displaying these, of course, is just the way they are. They will stand up on their own on a shelf or a ledge or a bookcase or whatever, and they become little art objects. And what I love about these as art objects is they do move around slightly with the breeze, and so they kind of take on a little dynamic mobile Alexander Calder mobile kind of property to them. And also the amount of curvature to the paper kind of changes a little bit with the humidity and temperature, so there is a little bit of breathing. These things almost act like they may be alive. There's a certain life to them. And the downside might be, if you're thinking about it in terms of archival properties, the downside of displaying these photograms like this is that the silver gelatin prints are not protected from the environment. They're not in a glass frame. But that is kind of the trade-off you have for having these as physical objects. Now, there's one more aspect to this I'd like to talk about, which is these prints are silver gelatin. What that means is the dark tones and the grays, everything that's not absolutely paper white in the image, is oxidized silver. It's metallic silver in an oxidized state, suspended in a gelatin emulsion coated onto a paper support. And as such, it is a metallic image. This is a metal image. Silver gelatin prints are metal images. And so the silveriness of the frame takes on or kind of mirrors that same metallic appearance to the image itself. So there's aluminum silvery colored frame, steel wire, and a metallic silver image. Well, I hope you like this idea. These are pretty easy to do, and there's a lot of possibilities here with these little pictures. Well, I hope this gave you guys some good creative ideas for how to take little photograms of objects and display them in a setting that might be fun to do. This is all pretty easy to do. I think the hardest part of it is just getting your darkroom set up, getting a darkroom space set up so you can do contact printing, basically a light tight area like a bathroom that you can make light tight, set up three little trays black and white paper chemistry, and have a little surface where you can put your paper out on, lay the object on top of it, a sheet of glass and a light source that you can operate from a timer. That's pretty much all you need to do contact printing, and it's real simple. Some of my earlier videos talk about doing simple darkroom layouts. So I hope this gives you guys some ideas for how you can get in the darkroom, play around with some silver gelatin paper, and make some nice little objects like this that might look good in your house and as gifts. Well, until next time, stay creative, and you have yourselves a great day.